There's the first chick. It's hatched. And it's moving around the incubator. It's trying to get close over. There's another one hatching.
I don't see him.
Yeah, you see him. Right. Oh, well, let me get that close. Right there. I don't know if you can see the little yellow beak just moving around there in the hole. Yeah, I'll stop bumping into the camera. Right, that's it. This egg right there is hatching. Well, here it comes. This one was pipped the first thing this morning already at, about 7 o'clock this morning it had pipped. And it hasn't done much all day, but here it is going to town. Breaking off the top or bottom or whichever way you want to call it. The fat end of the egg. That's the end that the air sac's in. So they orient themselves that way before they're gonna hatch. So they can open up the air sac and breathe that air and then start their journey to the big wide world. And see what's going on with the other baby over here. He's climbing all over everybody else. Won't be long. It was very cute today. If I clucked at the incubator like a hen, you could hear the chicks peeping away. Come on, little guy. Boys, if you want to see this one hatch out, you better come here. Quick, quick. Oh, the incubator light just turned on so we can see better. Yay. Look.
Which one? Anyone see him?
That one over there.
Here, I don't see it. Is he big? Is he big?
He's gonna come out. Look, I'll shine the light on him. See? Right there.
He's not moving.
Yeah, look.
He is? Is he moving?
You watch him.
He's going to hatch right out. There's like the other one's moving?
Yep.
It's like he came out right.
Mm-hmm. Out. You just watch him. He's gonna come out.
Really?
Yeah, he's pushing the top right off. See? Look.
Pushing it?
Mm-hmm.
So we can see?
Well, so he can get out. He's going to break the top off.
Oh, he's going to break the bottom off too?
Well, he's going to break it in half.
Half?
Mm-hmm. Break the egg shell in half.
In half?
Mm-hmm. So he can get out.
He's going to break it like this?
Sorta. You watch. Uh-oh, my batteries is done. Sorry for the interruption. My batteries ran out. Honey, don't put your arm over. You're blocking the light. Okay. He's starting to pop right out. Come around the other side of me, Neil, and then you can see better. Taking a little rest. And his buddy's chirping at him, saying, come on.
He said,
come on out.
Wake up. Come on, wake up.
Mm-hmm. He's probably tired. It looks like he's probably taking a little rest.
Maybe he's probably taking a little rest instead.
That's what it looks like.
That's what it looks like?
This is the fourth egg about to hatch. You can see chick number 3 there sitting behind it. There he comes. Oh, light. We back up, we can see the first chick that hatched is over there in the top right hand side. It's starting to dry out. And over there in the bottom right hand corner now, you can see the second chick to hatch. Oh, apparently it's gonna get a little help. Nice if we can get off them, I'm sure. Well, thanks to the other guy, he's out of the shell now. Glass is getting a little bit foggy. All the humidity in there. Let's see if I can find the spot. There we go. So you can see the wet chick just laying there, and he'll rest for a few minutes before he gets up and does anything. Looks like he's... coming from one of the white eggs, I think. Can't quite tell. Through here, the one sitting on top of them is from a cream egg. And the guy that was over there in the corner, the dark one, you can't really see him very well right now. He was from a green egg. And the one that's on the other side of the fence was from a blue egg. I'm trying to keep him separate because there's only two of those and I'd like to know which ones they were. Alright, there we go. I cleared the glass a bit, light came on. Woo! That's what you get for climbing all over each other. And there's the new guy, fresh out of the shell. Number 3 and 4. There's number 1 again over there. Oop, and there's number 2 on this side of the fence. Number 2 was the first one to pit. That was about 7 o'clock this morning, and now it's almost 8:30 at night. So, but a full 12 hours from when these guys first started to pit, before they started coming out into the big wide world. And he's all wet. He'll probably sit around and rest a little bit before he does a whole lot. This is the first large size egg to hatch. See him? He's right beside the chick. Come here, Bethany. Pipping his way around, breaking the shell around the top in a circle. And here he comes. Chicks like to call to each other to encourage each other to get out. Just like the mama hen would, she would cluck to the chicks. This is the only brown egg with brown speckles I had on it, and I was thinking that it might be from the barred rock. And the chick's dark, so I think I might have been right, which is really exciting. And this one's probably going to be a surprising amount bigger than the other chicks that we've seen so far, and the other chicks in there, because they're from bantam-sized eggs. And this chick is from a regular full-sized egg. So you can see that he's all wet. And wet, he's probably about the same size as that other chick is, and it's pretty much dry. So once he gets all fluffed up, he's going to look a fair amount bigger. And he'll probably take a rest for a little bit now before he gets doing a whole lot, so there you go.